Bats may not be the cutest or most popular wildlife, but giving them a helping hand is more important than ever. News 8's Jack Hubley has why in today's Wild Moment.
The summer of 2011 has certainly been a wet one, great for mosquito production. At the same time, it's been a bad year for our number one nighttime mosquito eater, the bat. Bat populations here in the Northeast have been decimated by a relatively new fungal disease called white nose syndrome. So bat conservation is more critical than ever. That's why I was happy to hear from Sarah Caldwell. She writes, "I live in downtown Lancaster. There's a small walkway about 3 feet wide by 10 feet high between my house and my neighbor's house. Recently, while taking out the trash, my fiance was shining a flashlight down the walkway, and we happened to notice a bat dangling upside down from the ceiling. How can I make my walkway a more attractive hangout for bats to help control our mosquito population?" First of all, Sarah, bless you for not labeling your roosting bat a problem and trying to solve that problem with a tennis racket. A little brown bat, the most common bat in our area, can catch 2,000 to 3,000 flying insects, many of them mosquitoes, in a single night. So killing these mosquito-eating machines makes no sense at all. In your case, Sarah, you already know that your walkway is an acceptable bat hangout. I recommend that you build or buy at least 2 bat boxes. Mount one in your walkway and a second in your backyard. You can find bat house plans on the Pennsylvania Game Commission's website, or you can get this great little booklet from the Penn State Extension Service entitled A Homeowner's Guide to Northeastern Bats and Bat Problems. It's also available on the Extension's website. For those of you who discover bats in your attic in the summer, go ahead and plug up the entry holes that you can find. But please wait until the fall, after the bats have left your attic and gone underground for the winter. Sealing bat entryways in the summer will result in the death of any baby bats that are not yet able to fly. More than ever, it's time to learn to live with bats, or with lots more mosquitoes. Take your pick. I'm Jack Hubley, News 8.